previously on Clear Shampoo Presents Checkmate. The final 16 faced the first task. Both teams tried their best to impress the judges, managing director and marketing head of Ideas 91 by coming up with an in-store and digital campaign for their brand RD.
Hello and welcome to Clear Shampoo Presents Checkmate, hunt for the smartest young executive in the Middle East.
Now, as you saw the recap, lots of things happened in the last episode. Lots of ups, lots of downs, which basically have led to this, the judgment episode. Yeah?
Yeah.
So let's get things started.
All right, to find out who makes it through and who doesn't, teams, let's have you in. Wow, look at you all. This is the judgment episode. You've done the hardest part, the task is over, and it's time now for us to find out the results.
But before we do that, can we have our judges, please? Presentations were made, questions were answered, and now it is time for the eliminations. But before that, I want to ask both the teams, okay? You have 1 minute of time each. Give me one name, and only one name, of one of the members who performed the best amongst all of you in your teams, okay? And you can't take your name, mind you. Who is that one person going to be, if I were to ask? 1 minute, take your time and think.
Abel, you, I don't know.
I divided the work in such a way that nobody could judge who worked the most or the least. So the work was very well divided amongst everybody. So the time when the judges asked us, they said, please, who would you suggest to be the best? We had no answer because everybody had put in their 100% and equal amount of effort.
Randhir is a really good captain and we enjoyed ourselves. I loved the way he delegated the responsibilities. And all of us got a chance to express ourselves and what we wanted.
Time's up. All right, guys, let's start with Team A. Do we have a name?
Yes, my teammates have suggested my name.
Okay, can you stand up, please?
From what happened today, I think Rashi was a strong contender. I think she's good at business and marketing, so she knows what she's doing.
And Team B, do we have a name there?
Aarti.
Okay. Aarti, can you please stand up?
The only reason why we put up Aarti was because she missed out a bit in the middle. I backed her up over there. But later on, when the time came, like, you know how people get nervous. Once they go down, they just break. They don't come up. But we saw her. Like, even after going down, she had the capability to come back.
I think Ashna Pandey also really did a very good job in her opening. I don't know who... I was really happy that I was voted as the best, but probably it's because of the little experience that I have in the corporate world.
I think Aarti, and in my opinion, even Adarsh, deserved the best people in our group who did a good job because they really carried our group, they really, you know, leaded our group, and they made our group understand a few things which was going above our head while we were not able to understand. So I think Yashi and Adarsh really deserved it.
Aarti was clearly a good performer because she was persuasive in whatever she said. She persuaded the judges, everyone, about her part, about the campaign. We were leading the advertising campaign, and she was very clear about what we wanted and how we wanted the consumers to come to know about the product. So yeah, she deserved to be the best performer.
Aaj chahe jo marzi team ghar jaye, but you two are safe.
So, well done.
Well done.
You both added incredible value to your team, so thank you for that. And please do go take a seat. We come to the next part of the judgment episode. If there's one thing Sid and I can see from a mile after all our years in radio, it's confidence. And the confidence that we saw in you, Rashi, was pretty incredible. So we are going to name you close-up Miss Confidence of the day, and you win yourself a nice big hamper full of goodies from close-up.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
I'm clear. I have nothing to hide. This is who I am. Today is the day when I won Miss Confidence, but that day isn't far when I'll be the winner of Checkmate. Watch me.
And Ab, that time jo sabki hawaiyan udane wala hai elimination part.
Right. Rohit and Deepika have been watching you both. They've been watching both the teams, how you worked, how you presented, and of course, most importantly, your ideas. So you guys, do you have a judgment?
Yes, we'd like to say both the teams worked really hard. We thank both the teams. It was a very close decision. For us, what decided it in favor was there was a team that selected the market segment, did a little more than the other team on the health aspect. They created a little more around that campaign, and they did a little more research on the product, etc. So the winning team is Team B.
Well done, guys. Congratulations. Each and every one of you. Well, RD guys want you to be ekdam healthy, so they're giving you a ceramic kettle. Each and every one of you wins that. Now, if I can please ask all of you to step out.
I feel amazing. It's our first win, and we all are safe. Nobody gets eliminated.
I think we were not on the right track. We were more focused about the product rather than our idea.
So, Team B, the champions of the day. Lekin Team A mein, what went wrong? We'll find out after the break.
Yeah, we will. You better stick around on Clear Shampoo Presents Checkmate. Hunt for the smartest young executive in the Middle East.
So, all of you worked very hard. We really appreciate all your inputs and everything. The person we selected, I won't say the worst, as the weak link of the team, we believe started off very well, took a lot of responsibility on himself, but then he lost his way.
Well, they're safe, but we can't really say the same about you. Rashi, you're safe. So feel good about that, but only for a few minutes.
I was really happy, but then I felt a little bad for my team. But I felt like I did contribute quite a bit towards the ideas that were given today by my team. But yeah, I think the judgment today was really fair.
The rest of you, on the other hand, not so much. We're going to let Rohit and Deepika tell us who they thought the worst performing member of the team was.
So, all of you worked very hard. We really appreciate all your inputs and everything. The person we selected, I won't say the worst, as the weak link of the team, we believe started off very well, took a lot of responsibility on himself, but then he lost his way, and that was Abel for us. He lost his way because he took on the full responsibility of managing the full digital side of the team, but he did not take it to its complete execution. So we are sorry, Abel, you're a great guy, you took on a great responsibility, but according to us, you were the weak link in the team.
Abel should not have gotten eliminated. That's a fact. And I can't believe in myself that he's still out. I mean, out of all of the people, I don't know why they had to pick him. He was the one who was driving us to actually finish the task. And they were just yammering on and on and on. And they didn't do... And I mean, he was the one who drove us to actually do something. We were just giving an input, oh, here, we want to do this, oh, I have this idea, that. But there was nothing that was happening. And Abel was the one who told us, okay, just start doing what you've got to do.
It's also our group's fault because he, when we got the task, he was just like, he wants to do digital marketing. And we responded to that like, okay, fine, you know, you can deal with it, because he showed a lot of enthusiasm towards it. Like, he knew what he was doing.
I gave in my best shot. And if I compare myself to my teammates who I worked with, I've done far, far better than them.
We also, as a group, didn't pay much attention to what he was doing when he was doing the digital marketing part. Where I kind of feel bad, because obviously as a group we should have known what he was working towards. Maybe we could have avoided the situation we faced today.
Well, I will accept and take the responsibility. As per what the judge said, he said I deviated from the topic. I will stick to his opinion, and yes, I deviated.
Unfortunately, Abel, that means that you will be leaving us today and you won't be part of the tasks in the weeks to come. Thank you so much for being a part of the show and good luck with all your endeavors.
All right, thank you so much.
We're going to ask you to please leave the room.
Good luck. Thanks, man. Bye-bye.
I was really shocked about the eliminations. I mean, we were waiting outside and then we saw Abel coming out first and we were so, especially me, like I was so shocked because I felt like Abel was that kind of person when we interacted first, like during on the first day. He was that kind of person who was like so well spoken. He knew how to, you know, express his opinions. He knew how to, a really intellectual kind of guy. He always knew what to say at the right time.
The moment I came to know that Abel was eliminated, I was a bit off because he was the one who was looking well prepped, you know, right from the start. Like he would keep his collar up and be like, yes, I am here to nail it.
Abel is an amazing person. He is very talented. He got knocked out soon. And I didn't expect him to go out.
I don't know what must have gone wrong there by his part. Maybe it was just his luck. But I was very shocked when that happened.
I was disappointed at the first place, but if you let your team down, even if it's a one person's mistake, your whole team goes down, not only you.
Thank you, Deepika. Thank you, Rohit, for contributing so much to today's episode and contributing so much to this task. It was a pleasure working with you all.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Not such a great day for Abel today. The judges chose him, but the teammates, who are they going to choose to eliminate? Well, we'll find out right after the break.
This is Clear Shampoo Presents Checkmate, hunt for the smartest young executive in the Middle East.
Who did you not win the challenge because of? Who contributed least? You will write that name on that white piece of paper and you will show it to us. And of course, you will show it to your teammates. And we'll find out who contributed the least to the team and the task.
All right, Team A, Abel is out. Any ideas why you guys were not the winners tonight?
I think that we established the positive facts of a ceramic kettle, but we weren't able to emphasize it in our campaign enough.
Yeah, I think we started off really well, but in the middle or by the end, we got off track from the
top. Can I just tell you one thing? You guys had 15 minutes.
Yeah. Yes.
The other team also had 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Unka presentation was finished with 4 minutes left. And you guys had not finished your presentation even in the 15 minutes. You guys were beating around the bush a lot.
According to me, what went wrong was the decision making or the opinions of people that they weren't really able to judge properly. Not the judges, but the people, my teammates, fellow teammates.
I do have something to add to that. You know, you spent so much time explaining to the two people who knew this brand the best about the brand. You know what I mean? Nobody knows this brand better than they do, and they don't need to hear what their company is all about or what their product is about. They need to understand how you see the product and how you see it in stores and how you see it expressed on digital media and social media and things like that. So I think if the big idea had come a little earlier on, you would have been able to win their hearts. Yeah? So now let's get to the interesting bit.
Is it interesting?
Now we know why you didn't win the challenge. But who did you not win the challenge because of? Who contributed least, according to you guys in the team? And don't answer that loudly. Rashi, I'm going to ask you to hand one out to each person and hand them these pens as well. It is not anonymous. Everybody will know whose name you wrote on that piece of paper. You will write that name on that white piece of paper and you will show it to us. And of course, you will show it to your teammates. And we'll find out who contributed the least to the team and the task.
Ready? Okay. Go for it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, everybody's written? All right. Kashi.
Really, why?
Let's start with you, Captain.
I've written Vidhi's name. I voted Vidhi because I felt like from her side, I just found more criticism than any ideas. And I felt like as I or anybody else was recommending any ideas, she was telling us what was wrong with it instead of suggesting what we can do right with it, which isn't anything that I'm looking down upon, but I would have preferred if she gave us some constructive criticism. Amen.
I also gave Vidhi's name. Mm-hmm. And I would second Rashi on this opinion of hers that there weren't really ideas coming in.
After when you are done with a task, you don't come out and you start blaming or pinpointing a person for his mistakes or her mistakes. You are a team. After all, you're working all together. You need to own a mistake and you shouldn't do like that. So when she came out, she was like discouraging everybody, like you did this wrong, you couldn't speak, you did this thing, which is not right.
I am known to criticize people's work, but I don't do it to put one down. I do it because I feel that we can generate more ideas based on that. But obviously every individual is different. If it doesn't work out with some groups and it works out with some groups, like I have to make myself adhere to which group it works to and which it doesn't. So I kind of learned from my mistakes today and I will certainly not do that again because that was the reason why my name did come up.
Sachi. I didn't see these criticism, but for me I wrote Emin because if it was contributed the least, then I'd say that. I know she did the poster and I know she sent it last minute, but the problem was that even if the poster was in the presentation, it wasn't good enough.
Vidhi?
I give Ayman's name to my spelling, excuse it. But contribution-wise, I felt like it was not up to the mark.
I'd give Nathan's name. That's only because he was more focused towards the introduction part, which I felt.
I nominated Nathan because there was a misconception to me that he did not really focus on the right topic because it was my misunderstanding that I took it like he went for the topic of the introduction instead of the main ad campaigns that we were told to do. So this was my mistake on nominating Nathan for this.
I say Mohit because he was doing his job but not pouring his ideas into the teamwork because we were all were like, you know, pitching our ideas like, you know, in a creative fields, and because he was just working on it and whatever we are saying. So I want Mohit in the future task also to pitch his ideas like we everyone does, like in the future task.
In the end, it became a blame game and that is not what team is about. You don't blame people like that.
I would say Ayman because although I believe she had done her task, but the thing was it wasn't uploaded to the laptop, so all her work was just gone in vain.
I didn't like how Nathan actually pinpointed and said that all my contribution went to waste just because it wasn't uploaded. Excuse me, I did all my job. I put in a lot of hard work. I did the whole poster, like you can still go and see it. Can I justify that? Because I had uploaded it and I had also sent it, but Sachi was making the presentation. So it wasn't the mistake at my end because I had made the presentation within time and I'd also mailed her. So it's not my fault that it wasn't in the presentation. I could have used this against the other team members as well, saying that, you know, I did my bit, but it was never showcased in the presentation. It never came through.
But the thing is, I got it 30 seconds before the time was up.
Yeah.
So there was no time. I couldn't have done anything in that time.
Sachi is very diplomatic when it comes to this thing. And everybody at the end of the day wants to win the game, wants to win the show, and which is not bad. But just don't go too down the lane, like too below. Don't just fall so much that, you know, you're not able to face your own self one day.
So, Emin, that's a checkmate on you. Can we please ask you to leave the room?
Yeah, sure, it's all right. Thank you so much. Thank you.
And good luck.
You're welcome.
Good luck for all your future projects.
I think the people who are weakening our team have actually left. obviously, if they could give in their best, maybe we could have won. But the main reason why we didn't win was because we could not manage the time properly.
Aimin is a very nice girl. She's a very sweet girl, and her cause, she was married and she had the support of her husband throughout. So I think that is a message to many girls and to many people out here, and her leaving the show is a shock, definitely.
Anybody heaving a sigh of relief?
Me.
We could hear that.
Anyone glad to see that Abel and Eamon are out? Maybe it'll be a more efficient team now.
Maybe, but we could have also done with their help.
Yeah.
Shouldn't you have voted out the best performing member? That way you would have less competition?
No.
Okay, just thinking.
You do know, each and every task, there are different teams which are made. So it's not that you guys are voting for one person. Right?
True.
The teams are shuffled, each and every task. Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, good luck. Congratulations, you survived it. Just about.
Living in Dubai is not easy. It is difficult. And I have taken the initiative to support my parents by starting up my own side businesses. And I've been independent for a really long time.
I feel very bad because this was like a golden opportunity for me, which just slipped out of my hand. But it's okay. I feel really glad and really proud of myself that I made it through. And it's a huge deal for me.
Every successful man has had failures. I'm just considering this as one of my failures.
I was here for my parents and my husband, especially my parents. I really wanted to make them proud, and I just hope I have made them proud.
I want to be the boss. I don't want to be the, you know, the monkey in the cage.
I've showcased all Pakistani girls and represented them that we're no less than anybody, and we have got it all in ourselves. It's just that we need a platform to showcase our, or we need a chance to just showcase our talent, and we're no less than anybody here.
Well, the task has ended, but unfortunately, so have some friendships. But I guess that's the way it goes. Two eliminations out of the way.
Absolutely. Now, next week, naya task. And naya task ke saath saath, naya skill set is going to be worked out on. So up, we say ciao. But we'll see you next week right here on Clear Shampoo Presents Checkmate. Hunt for the smartest young executive in the Middle East.
Next week, the contestants are put through a task what they are not expecting to come their way.
The end ambition is for you to express, bringing you closer to your dreams. However you want to express that as a team, you can go ahead and do just that.
Find out what the task is, and to know how the teams do in it, be sure to watch.